design inspirations of New Mexico are as diverse as our land itself. And in the April edition of New Mexico Magazine, we explore the eclectic, eccentric, and incredible homes that populate our rolling hills and deserts from ABQ to Las Cruces.
Yes, here to lead our journey is Dave Herndon, editor-in-chief of New Mexico Magazine. Dave, it's always a pleasure. So let's talk about the cover of the magazine. It's an eco-contempo house in Corrales, right?
Right. So there's a couple called the Freemans. Mm-hmm. The wife has a background as an environmental engineer, mm-hmm. who specializes in corporate sustainability, et cetera. And her husband is works at Intel, and he's also a builder. Mm-hmm. They're putting a high premium on using sustainable materials, mm-hmm. recycled materials, high premium on energy efficiency.
Yeah.
And they worked with an architect to create something that, is aesthetically pleasing to their lifestyle, mm-hmm. and it fits in their Corrales neighborhood, too. Mm-hmm. So it's not like a glass and steel,
right.
modern monstrosity. The writer of this piece, Charles Poling, calls it an example of regional modernism, mm-hmm. which I think is a key concept. As we get into the 21st century, our homes need to evolve.
Yeah.
But we don't want to abandon the look and feel of New Mexico.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So this is what I call post-Adobe.
Post-Adobe,
yeah.
There you go. I trademarked that phrase.
You should.
I got a million of them.
Yeah, that's good.
So, I think that shows us the way forward,
yeah,
for
absolutely.
21st century,
yeah.
New Mexico style. It's one example of many, but it's a really good example.
Yeah, it's beautiful architecture.
And it's not, it's not a McMansion.
Yeah,
and,
that's
for
sure.
That, we can all be thankful that, there are people here, finding yeah. another way forward.
Yeah, yes. Now there's also, if we want to go more traditional, there's this next one. It's globally inspired, though. This is
right.
a very traditional house in ABQ. This is John Bassard's house.
Right.
So let's talk about this style, because he's holding on to those traditions that we're talking about. Is
right.
that right?
He is a gallery owner who has his home in ABQ. Mm-hmm. And his gallery specializes in tribal and global art and artifacts. Mm-hmm. A lot of it devotional, so from trips to Asia, trips to Africa, trips to South America, he brings it back. And it fits into an old adobe that he's got, in ABQ, mm-hmm. Extremely well. And I think that says something else about New Mexico architecture. There are more homes in this world that are made of clay, straw, and mud than there are, bricks and
right.
And steel.
Right.
So that's why New Mexico style, I think, is accommodating mm-hmm. to ethnic influences from around the world, and all kind of fits together. It's
yeah.
not jarring. Yeah. It doesn't feel, there's an exotic element to it, mm-hmm. but it fits.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. So fans of architectural design will want to head south to Las Cruces because they have styles that are inspired by Spanish and Mexican
right.
design.
Well, Las Cruces is a bastion of borderland culture.
Yeah.
Which is another, very rich aspect of what New Mexico has going on.
Mm-hmm.
And these traditional homes down there, merge Spanish influences, Mexican influences, and of course, northern ones. And there's some incredible houses. There's one called La Fantasia mm-hmm. that was put together by a woman named Clara Franger in the first part of the 20th century.
Mm-hmm.
She hired Mexican craftsmen, took them 20 years to build it, and she was a party girl, she was an entertainer.
Mm-hmm.
So she put in a loft for musicians,
yeah.
like a choir loft, and a mariachi pit.
Mm-hmm.
And stuff I'd like that. And an aviary that
yeah.
she opened up for birds to be able to fly.
Yeah.
Kind of cool.
It's a very eccentric
but,
design. And that one really caught my eye. I got to say
right.
that one looked very cool.
Yes.
Also going on down in Las Cruces, though, aside from the architecture,
yes.
Mesilla has got so many great, beautiful pieces of architecture. But I understand Las Cruces is getting ready to host their inaugural country music festival.
Right.
Is that right? What are the details on that?
So at the last weekend of April, there's a big country music festival. It's held outdoors, and sort of what I call the gray ponytail set. There's the Charlie Daniels band,
yeah, yeah,
bringing the classic,
uh-huh.
Kind of southern rock. But then they have some younger stars and entertainers. Mm-hmm. Bri Bagwell is one of them. She's a Las Cruces girl who's doing well in the national scene, and
mm-hmm.
Cassidy Pope, who's been a winner on The Voice and American Idol, stuff like that. Yeah. So something for everybody. Yeah. And some local bands on other stages at different times. Yeah. There's also a college, NMSU is hosting an NCAA rodeo that weekend. Mm-hmm. And there's a Border Book Festival that weekend.
Wow.
Hosted by another one of these people that has one of these great houses in Las Cruces.
Yeah.
So busy
stuff going on in Cruces.
The last weekend of April is going to be the place to be.
Yeah, definitely.
Absolutely. Well, folks, for more information, head over to our website at casa.com. Mm-hmm. Click on the style tab. We'll have links to nmmagazine.com there. All right.